I'm John Lovelace, and today we're going to do a really neat experiment. We are going to measure the efficiency of a cooking device. Here we have an induction cooktop, a kilowatt power meter, measures power in kilowatt hours. We also have a quart of water, and the water temperature right now is 71 degrees. So I'm going to write that down, 71 degrees Fahrenheit. This is exactly 1 quart of water. And what we're going to do is we're going to measure the energy that it takes to heat up this water using an induction stove. Now, I'll show you in a minute, there's a theoretical equation that tells you that it should take so much energy in a perfect system to raise water a certain amount of degrees. And then in this one, we're gonna measure it, and it's gonna be not as efficient because it's not a perfect system. So we're also gonna start the clock here. So I'm gonna just start cooking here. We'll see what happens here. Let's just crank it up full blast, shall we? So here we are on solid 9. It is drying. 14, I don't know if you can see this from this camera view, but 1480 watts for the highest level on this cooktop. So now all we do is we sit and wait. I'm going to measure this temperature here. Well, actually, we're a little ways away, 162 degrees. Now, I should point out that none of these pieces of measuring equipment are calibrated. So there is going to be error in our precision that we can make to these measurements, the accuracy. So this is just a rough measurement that we're going to be doing. But it will show the efficiency. Interesting, the power level has gone up to about 1520 watts. So as this cooktop has warmed up, it's actually drawing a little bit more power. 0, 1, 2, just barely clicked over to 1.2 kilowatt hours. All right, now we're up to 188 degrees. So I'm gonna go with 188 and 1.2 kilowatt hours for a quart of water. So we're gonna stop right there. Store. Okay, we're gonna do this again, this time with the lid off, so uncovered. So we've got another quart of cold water, or tap water. It's 1 quart. We're going to measure its temperature. It's about 71 and a half. It's just about a half degree higher than it was the first time. 71 and a half degrees. And let's start it up and see how it goes. 1500 watts, 1506, 1512. This really is an amazing technology. The energy is being transferred from the coil directly to the pan, not heating up this stove. That is a really neat technology. All right, we've got a slow simmer coming on here. Doesn't want to get it boiling though, of course we're watching the pot, and we all know what happens when you watch a pot. Doesn't boil. Where are we at here? 176. Interesting. It's taking about the same amount of time. Nope, actually it's taking more energy. So we're at 120 so far. 181. Collected our data now. We've entered in the temperatures between hot and cold that we heated the water to using the induction cooktop covered and again uncovered. And we've also entered the watt hours of energy that it took to do those things. And here over here is the theoretical of how many BTUs or how many watt hours of energy it would take to heat up a theoretical perfect stove. So comparing a theoretical one to reality, the covered cooktop ended up being almost 60% efficient. The uncovered was about a little over 50%. So really good in comparison to other things. That's a really good efficiency. Here we have the efficiencies of different water heating devices. You've got the water heaters, a gas water heater, electric, the electric range, microwave oven, and induction cooktop. And as you can see, the induction cooktops are really efficient as far as kitchen cooking appliances. So there you have it. Thanks for watching. Bye.